Heidi, the dog reporter here at Crufts, and I have found Sean, president of the Irish Kennel Club, and I'd love to learn more about the Irish native breeds. Can you tell me a little bit about them?
Yeah, the Irish are kind of great dog people because most of our dogs, though, would be kind of general purpose dogs because generally we were a poor nation. I think Britain kept us that way for a couple of centuries, but we kind of had multi-purpose dogs. For instance, our terriers were very rarely specialists. They were nearly always guard dogs, family companions, sheep herders. They had to be a bit versatile and they kind of a reflection of the farming community and the people that were there at the time. I suppose the Wolfhound is the exception because they were the dog of the Kings of Ireland, and their stature and pure build made them a very noble looking dog. And I think, as I mentioned earlier on, they're involved a lot in our history and our myths. The others were our gun dogs. Probably the more unique one would be the Irish Water Spaniel. And there's some histories about the Spanish galleons going down off the west coast of Ireland, and one of the dogs, a Portuguese water dog, swimming ashore and mating a local collie or something. But we don't really know how the Water Spaniel. All we do know is that it's a very interesting looking breed and has a clownish personality, a very silly personality that likes to be a fun dog all its life. A very enthusiastic worker too when it's working in water. The Terrier is probably the more oldest breed, I would say, is the Irish Terrier. They have that red, very distinct, hard red coat, and probably the original Irish Terrier. But then, when they were breeding terriers at the time, they were breeding for specific working qualities like ratting and badger drawing and killing vermin. And that, rather than the actual visual beauty of the dog, was important. So they developed types. The red-coated, harsh-coated one, the soft-coated wheaten one, and the Kerry Blue. And one that might be a little bit specialist, which would be the Glen of the Mall, because it's different in stature. Funny thing about that, if you look at its colourings, it's quite similar to the Irish Wolfhound. They have the same colourings and the same coat, and they also have a very massive head for a small dog and very heavy boned. So I don't know how it could have happened, but I have a feeling somewhere along the line, a couple of centuries ago, the giant and the tiny mini-me were somewhere involved. The Kerry Blue was probably proposed as the national dog of Ireland during the Civil War in Ireland, when we did what Irish always do. When we finally got our freedom, we decided to fight each other then, you know, so as we make sure everything was cleared out of the way. And the Kerry Blue, because Michael Collins, one of the guys who was involved in our fight for freedom, he had Kerry Blues and bred them. And because of that, there was a proposal that they would be named as the National Dog of Ireland. It actually went to the Parliament in Ireland, but whatever happened, Michael Collins was shot in the meantime, and the bill was kind of never followed through. So we don't know to this day.
So do you have an official Dog of Ireland then?
We don't really. I suppose people, the concept worldwide would be the Irish Wolfhound, probably because of its stature, and I'd say that's probably what we're more known about. But I think the one thing about that is, yes, we're quite happy to take that and it's part of our mythology, but except for a quirk of history, the Kerry Blue would have been. We have eight breeds, and probably the lesser known one would be the Kerry Beagle, which is a kind of large hound like a Blue de Gascoigne or Coonhound size, and there's very few of them, mainly hunting packs. They do drag hunting, and they need to be revived and steadied up properly, but I don't know if the will is there among people. We as a kennel club will try and do it, but hopefully people will cooperate. The Glen of Amal seems to be getting stronger. It's getting a bit more popular because it's a natural dog, and if you get it right or buy the right dog, you know, you can be lucky. There's not the extensive preparation for you to win that other breeds have.